So, we see here also the Fugue 16, but the Fugue 16 become more working because we have now a pile rahmen frame for the ranging. Yeah? And so was the name Fugue 16 Y. Now, ZY, Z for Zielflug, and Y for another type, I tell you, with this system, you can give the ground station where you are in the distance. Yeah?
Do you mean how far?
Yeah, how far.
How far you
are. How far I am. And the ground station sends a signal, and this is a transponder, yeah, and give back his number, and so they can see, aha, he is in this distance, and they can directed him to the enemy planes, yeah. So, and what you see here is the green ground. This is the original ground was also so in the Messerschmitt 109 and was also in the Messerschmitt 262. Yeah, here you can see pictures from this in the Messerschmitt 262, and here is a picture from the Messerschmitt 109. I hope this is correct. Yes. Yeah. So on this panel was this wood, but was painted with paint against fire and against water, yeah. So, and very important, the very small companies, got this parts. Not the system, only the ground parts and all the other parts. And they have to make the wiring, yeah, they have to make the wiring. And when they come back, this part, it come on this test panel, yeah, and it was tested. And when they made a mistake, yeah, not so many money, yeah. So, but now I will show you this system in working.
Sorry, you mean they didn't pay for the faulty item?
This panel and also the frames, yeah, came to small companies, very small companies with two, three people inside, and they have to make the wiring here, yeah. So. How it's here, and then it comes back, but not this radius. They got and they have not to know what I do there, but they know. But they have not to know what I do there. Only have to make from with a plan. Here are the cables and so, and then this comes back to the main airport. Yeah. And they put on every part on this and test is, make connection here, and test is, and when it's not working more and the man makes a little mistake, gives not so plenty money for this. Understood?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, gotcha. Good. And this I told me, this man, Mr. Handel, he was the boss from the test equipment here. Yes. From this I know this. From him I know this. Yeah. Okay. Now I show you.
Sorry, this. Remind me as you put those books up. You actually got those manuals from. Remind me again.
This was Mr. Handel, and he was the boss from the airport. Moment. From the airport was flying the first Messerschmitt 262. And also the first jet here you see, mm-hmm. Yeah. From this I got all the all the books and so on, yeah. And, but where was the airport? I forget. Yeah, and I also got from him this frame, some of the frame. This part he took away from the airport and make from the garden gate. Yeah, and he showed me this is also from his, I mean, the garden gate. He said, "Oh, back to me." Yeah, and so I may complete this in accordance with his talk. Here's the Fugue 16, and the special on the Fugue 16 ZY. Is the two antennas, this one, matching box, second, also matching box. This antenna was for the normally correspondence, yeah, but this antenna, and this antenna was special for the distance measurement, yeah, this antenna and this box. And on this antenna, you can change the length, but it was also a story because the animals go under the aircraft, broke this antenna. And so they make so. This is a story or this is true, I don't know. So every part was easy to change. Yeah? The same for the motor generator, the same for the transmitter. Okay, this is normally equipment in the aircraft, Messerschmitt 262, and also in the aircraft Messerschmitt 109. But here you see this is also again a test panel, yeah, and I will. On this test panel, you can test these equipments like we have seen before on the Fugue 16. Yeah. So, and now, this is again the heat. We have to heat the valves, but this all is in the cockpit. Yeah. So, and in the cockpit is also this switch. Yeah. And with this switch, the pilot can select different modes. Yeah. So and now I start. Yeah. So. And here's the knob to make he can talk. Normally he can talk. Yeah. This is knob. Yeah. Here in the middle, the two different frequencies for the normally contact to the ground station or to the other aircraft. Yeah. Here on this, position, yeah, you see the frequency is turning automatically, yeah. This is the frequency for the automatic different measurement range measurement, yeah, yeah. When the ground station send in on this frequency to him, he automatically sent back a signal, and so the ground station knows, in this distance is this aircraft. Yeah? So, yes, now I go back to the normal frequency. So, and for example, with this knob, you can adjust the receiver a little. I have shown you there, but not explained. Yeah, and I turn this knob. This is the receiver. Yeah, that you can better listen. Yeah, okay. And now I show. The Z function, yeah. You can find the station with this direction finder, but you have to go on this frequency. This is quarter. So. And now you can, you know this instrument. On this instrument you can see it's more left, more right of your direction. Yeah? But I cannot see, I cannot show you here, here is not any radio station what I can find. But the fighters have in the pocket such a emergency transmitter, yeah, and maybe some fighter is going down in the water, yeah. He took this radio out of his fore pocket, yeah. Put away this. So. And when you put away this, talks. So, moment. Now, the man in the water is left from the direction. Now, he is right from the direction. Yeah? And so, you can find him and you fly direct to him and can help him. Yeah? This is a special Vogel 16Z. Yeah, that was. Thank you.
Before we leave the Vogel 16, you may have noticed a small display in one corner of the room that appears in one or two of our shots. It shows an American-made SCR-522 radio set that seems a bit out of place in here. Built by the Bendix Corporation in the US and employed in the bombers and fighters of the US 8th Air Force from 1943, the set was an exact copy of the British TR-1143 system that had been in service with the RAF from 1942. The Allied Air Forces used the sets in ways similar to the Luftwaffe's use of the Vogel 16. So the SCR-522 or the TR-1143 sets are directly comparable to the Vogel 16. A few years ago, as an expert in wartime radio systems, Dieter made a direct point-for-point comparison between the German and Allied sets, expecting to confirm his long-held assumption that his German Vogel 16 radio was superior. The result was surprising.
What you see, I have made, I compare the English system with the German system. Radio station SCR-522 to the radio system we know Vogel 16. So I have compared this and I made also a list what is better, what is wrong. Yeah, but when you ask me, the English system is better. In Deutsch? Short, ne? Short, you see. Ehrlich sein soll, für den Krieg gemacht, ist die englische Anlage richtiger und besser.
Now I'm figuring you actually said for the German audience, the German is better.
No.
I know you didn't.
When I be true, okay, this... Explain. This is more technique, more better, and so. But for the war, you don't need so, so better, yeah. And when I see the English is better, I think I get more friends in England.
Yeah, and more friends in America.